poll numbers crash after Dem Senate candidate in Alabama calls own state an embarrassment. Doug Jones, the Alabama Democrat running for the Senate, crashed in the polls opening an 11-point lead for opponent Roy Moore after he was caught calling his own state an embarrassment. Recent Fox News polling had Jones neck and neck with his opponent Roy Moore. Before Jones' remarks, a Fox News poll had the two tied at 42% apiece. A Senate poll commissioned by Raycom News Network now shows Republican candidate Roy Moore with a double-digit lead of 11 points, the best polling yet for Moore. Moore had 51% support among those polled to Jones' 40%. 9% were undecided. The survey polled 3,000 likely Alabama voters. We here at Joe for America knew the Fox News poll was faulty for many reasons anyway, but great headline. Yes, recent and more accurate polling had Moore at between a 6 to 8 percentage point advantage. Sorry, Jones, you were never really neck and neck, but you said you were, so I am now saying that you have crashed in the polls, and you have. Any poll numbers that are good for me, I like them, said Jones in a recent interview. Now back to the important part, Jones' Obama-like apologetic and moronic comment. During a campaign stop in Rail Mobile, Jones was explaining that he's troubled by what he's seeing with the GOP. He then went on to attack opponent Roy Moore. After spewing the liberal talking points about the wealthy getting huge tax cuts while the poor suffer, he clearly stated, "We're at a point in this state that we can either go forward or backward," said Jones. "I'm tired of Alabama being an embarrassment around the country." Moore campaign chairman Bill Armistead blasted Jones for saying Alabama is an embarrassment in a press release. On Wednesday, the Liberal Democrat nominee for Senate Doug Jones said, "I'm tired of Alabama being an embarrassment around the country," as reported by John Sharp of Al.com. "Alabama needs a senator in Washington who is proud of this state, someone who will be a strong ambassador for Alabama. We don't need an Obama-like senator who goes on an apology tour for Alabama like President Obama did for America." Doug Jones' comments are reminiscent of the condescending remarks made by Barack Obama about people who bitterly cling to their guns and religion, Armistead observed. Yet it makes sense in a way. Doug Jones is a left-wing extremist who told MSNBC he doesn't support any restrictions on abortion. He clearly has little in common with the values of most Alabamians, so his disdain for our state is as sincere as his beliefs are extreme. A lifelong Alabamian, Roy Moore served this state and our country with distinction as an Army officer in Vietnam, Armistead said. Roy Moore will be a proud ambassador in Washington for our values and our people, should the people of this great state elect him senator on December 12. Suggesting that you are embarrassed by the state you are seeking to represent is a rather moronic move, but Jones is not new to self-destructive gaffes. Jones also stated he would not have voted to confirm Senator Jeff Sessions as Attorney General. That might work if you are running for Senator of California. Did he forget which state he's in? By most accounts, Jeff Sessions is the most popular Alabama politician in this generation. The last time Sessions ran for re-election, the Alabama Democratic Party could not even find a candidate willing to challenge him. Jones has also stepped in it with his pro-abortion remarks. "Alabama is one of the most pro-life states in the nation. Over 60% of Alabama voters support either totally banning abortions or at least severely limiting them." Jones went on MSNBC and said that he opposes any restriction on abortions, even in the ninth month, when the child is clearly viable outside of the womb. The winner of the December 12 election will complete the term of former Senator Jeff Sessions. Sessions left the Senate in February to serve as U.S. Attorney General. The full Senate term ends in 2020. Governor Robert Bentley had appointed Alabama Attorney General Luther Strange to fill the seat until a special election could be held. After the disgraced Bentley resigned from office, Governor Kay Ivey moved the special election to December. Strange, who lost to Moore in a runoff, will serve as senator until the December election is decided.